So is it possible to sell your home and buy a home at the same time? Find out here. Hi, welcome back to my channel. My name is Christian Medina, local realtor to the city of Chino and all of its surrounding areas. If you're new to this channel and you like the content, please hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, and don't forget to hit that bell. So if you're watching this video, you're probably in the situation where you currently own a home and it's no longer a fit for you. Maybe you have a growing family and you need to upsize, or maybe all the kids have moved out, you're empty nesters, and now you need to downsize because the house is too big for you. Or perhaps you're getting up there in age, you own a two-story home, and your knees just can't take going up and down the stairs anymore. So now you're thinking of making the move, and you question whether you can sell your house and buy a home at the same time. But you don't know what's gonna happen in the process. You may be thinking, how am I going to have a house to live in? How am I going to move? These are all valid questions. Simple answer is that you can't sell and buy at the same time. But the key to do that is to plan for it first. So here are the things that you need to do prior to going house hunting. Number one is to hire a trusted realtor like myself. And what the realtor is gonna do is they're gonna wanna come in, check out your house, look at all the features and benefits that your home has. That way they can go back, run comparables, do a comparable market analysis. And on the next meeting, they can give you an estimated value for your home. They will give you a presentation on how they arrived at that value. If the seller and the realtor agree on the price, the next thing the realtor will give you is a net sheet. The net sheet is going to give you a breakdown of all the costs that take place in selling your home. So they will go over broker fees, escrow fees, title fees, any other fees that can come up within escrow. And at the very end, they're going to give you an estimate of what you're going to walk away with at the close of escrow, which is something every seller would like to know, right? What's gonna go into their bank account. Once you have that number, now you can take that estimated number and meet with your lender. You can let your lender know that this is the amount of money that you're gonna invest on your next property. The lender will then go over some options with you. Based on them running your credit, the lender will then give you a breakdown for how much your down payment will be, what your closing costs will be, and go over all the loan options with you. If everything works out, you already know how much you're making off the sale of your home. You have the lender that's gonna give you a pre-approval letter, which is gonna tell you what you qualify for. And at that point, you should already have an estimate of what your monthly payment's gonna be on your new home based on the pre-approval letter. And you'll know up to what amount you're gonna be looking for homes at. Once you have all that, the next thing is to stage the house or make the house look presentable to all the buyers that will be walking into your property. And if you want ideas on what to do for your home, I already have a video made that discusses that. And you can find the link up here. Once the home is staged and it's in showing condition, the next thing is to get it listed with your agent. And then the agent will take care of all the photography, all the marketing, to be able to get you all the right buyers to walk through your home. I know as of right now, this is January 2021, we still have the whole COVID issue. And I, as an agent, already have all that figured out for you guys. Every possible buyer that walks through your home, before even showing them, they're gonna fill out what's called a PED, which is a property entrance advisory disclosure. Disclosure pretty much is saying that we all know that we're living in the COVID days. Before entering the property, they were to wear masks, they were to wear gloves. It also lets us know whether they've been around any people that have been infected with COVID or if they have COVID, and that pretty much they're entering at their own risk. You, the seller, will also sign one. After every showing, the buyer's agent or the listing agent will go around cleaning all the doorknobs, the light switches, anything possible that the buyer may have touched. Next, after we get all the offers we get for your property, we're gonna select one that makes the best sense for the seller. The next thing is we're gonna accept an offer. We're gonna let that buyer know that your home is contingent on you finding a replacement property. If we haven't found a home by then, we're gonna let them know that we're gonna need a certain amount of days in order for us to find the replacement property. I do have a breakdown on how the contingencies work, and you can find that up here somewhere. Once we have all that figured out, we're gonna want that buyer for your home to complete all their inspection. So they're gonna do their home inspection and any other inspections they wanna do, and also have the appraisal done. By getting those things done, we're gonna be way ahead of schedule once we find you a property. So when that's completed, now you wanna go out there and home shop. Because when you find the home that you really love, you can make an offer showing them that you already have a buyer for your property, you've already done all the inspections, the appraisal is already set in, and you're two steps ahead on your contract to be able to close on time with theirs. This is going to put you in a great position. When that seller's looking at offers, the first thing they're going to look at is highest and best. Sometimes the highest offer is not the best offer, but they're going to go through all the contracts, and if they see yours that's making a great offer, your home is already in escrow, you're already past the inspection contingencies, and just waiting on that loan approval, we're going to present to them the net sheet as your proof of funds, and that's going to make perfect sense for them to accept your offer over anyone else. Unless, you know, they have higher offers that make better sense, or maybe they have a cash investor that's coming in with all cash. But in most cases, you're gonna be in a really great position of getting that property, or at the very least, getting the counter. One thing you don't wanna do, and I'm having a lot of sellers coming to me with this idea, their idea is this. Their idea is to go house hunting first. Find that perfect house that they love, and then come back and do all the stuff I just mentioned. Sit down with the agent, sit down with the lender, stage it, then list a property, wait for a buyer to make an offer on their home, accept it, and now they want to go back to this seller and make an offer. Well, that's not going to happen. In this market right now, homes are moving fast. It's taking a week for them to sell, sometimes after the first week and they're gone. So no seller is going to wait for you to do all these other steps. Sellers want fast closings. So the people that are ready to go, close in 30 days or less, are the people that are going to get accepted. So don't make that mistake. Don't waste your time, because 99% of the time, that's not gonna work out. Finally, what you have to have is a plan B. Let's just say you put your house on the market, you get an offer on your house right away, you let them know that you're contingent upon finding a replacement home. Now you're out there looking, your offers aren't getting accepted, you're not seeing anything that you really like, then your plan B can either be just canceling the whole thing or selling the property to that buyer and having the place to stay. Maybe with a friend, a family member, Airbnb. Because at the very least, if you have this all figured out, you sell your home, you now have the money in your bank. When you're making offers on the next home, you don't have to write it as contingent upon selling your home. You're already ready to go. So that looks very attractive to the seller as well. Because now you're qualified, you have proof of funds, which is all the money from the sale of your home, and you're ready to go in 30 days or less. And that is the best way to go. So if you're looking to do this, and if you live in the Chino area or any of the cities nearby, let me know. You'll find my contact information below. Other than that, thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next video.